Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at what's new in Mac OS X Mavericks. So let's start by taking a look at two major new apps. The first one is iBooks. Now for a long time people have been asking for a Mac version of iBooks, and here we go. We've got it now. And basically this accesses the same account that you use for iBooks on the iPad and iPhone. So you'll have all your books there and you can download the ones that you want. And you can also go to the bookstore here and purchase books. So you've got the ability to do this here and in iTunes as well. In your library you can see the books that you've got. You can go into them. It's pretty straightforward. It does open in multiple windows, so you can have a window for the book and you can have a window for say, you know, the entire iBooks interface here with your books in it. And you can shrink the window. You can enlarge it. You've got all the same controls, maybe a little bit more for viewing here on the Mac that you do on the iPad. You've got bookmarks. You've got table contents. You have the ability to highlight things and then leave notes. And you can search. You can go into a very nice full screen mode and easily navigate using the keyboard. So there's a lot you could do here. You've also got the ability to use interactive books. So if we go back to the main library here, you can see I've got an interactive book here, and these are books specially made for the iBooks store that have lots of animation and video and sound and interactive things like quizzes and models, 3D models you can manipulate, things like that. So the other major app, of course, is Maps, and this is the equivalent to Maps on the iPhone and iPad. Apple's made it in an app rather than through a web browser, probably for speed. It can access the data in a custom way through an app instead of going through a web page. And it pretty much works as you would expect. You can bring things up. You can go for satellite views. You can go in and get directions. There's a 3D view in here, and you can zoom in, get the flyover data, move around. So it's pretty good. It's pretty much the equivalent to what you would expect. It's just you don't have to now reach for your iOS device to access all this. You can do it right here on your Mac. Now there have been two major improvements to the Finder. The first one is Tabs. So now you have a normal window here in the Finder. It looks pretty much the same as it did in Mountain Lion. I'm going to go to File, and instead of a new Finder window, I'm going to create a new tab. Command T is how you do it, just like in the browser. And now I've got two tabs I can look at, so I can easily navigate through both of them separately. And if I wanted to copy a file from one to the other, say I want to take one from WorkDocs here, I could drag it, move it to this tab here. It would open up, and then I could drop it there, and vice versa. You can see it appears there. So you've got tabs, which is very nice, and you can add as many as you want. It should clean up a lot of clutter here on the desktop. In addition, now we also have tags. So you can select a file that you want, and you've got tags button here is one way to add it. And you can see here I've got the colored labels that we had before. So labels now basically morph into tags, but instead of just being limited to just these colors, and that's all you can do, you can create your own. I've created two here. I can create another one by simply typing, and you can see I've created it and I've assigned it to this file there. I can go into here and you can see that that one's available too. I could add it for it, and I could add multiple ones. So project 1 and project 3 for that one. And then in the sidebar here you can see I've got those projects. I can go to basically little smart searches that show me those projects here. This will allow for better organizing. So you can say put your photos in a photos folder, put your videos in a videos folder, and if some of those photos and some of those videos are part of project 1, you can assign tags to them and then view them all together without having to move them out of their folders. So files don't really have to be in one place anymore. Very similar to having albums in iPhoto or playlists in iTunes. Now one app that's gotten a major overhaul is the calendar app. You can see here it looks completely different. It doesn't have any of that wood grain paper design going on here. It looks a lot more like the iOS stuff, and just a lot cleaner, white background. And there's some nice little features in it, being able to access maps and things like that. in the interface a little cleaner. It's just a much nicer display to look through, even though of course it's a calendar, so it basically does the same thing as previous calendars. So as you can see here, both Notes and the Contacts app have also gotten new looks to them, although functionality is basically the same, just a little streamlined. They're a little nicer to use now. And there's lots of little things, of course. There's always going to be tons of little changes. Sometimes people find those very useful. Like for instance, here in Battery, you can see it says Collecting Power Uses Information when I click on Battery. And it's actually going to come up with, after a little bit of time, some information about if there are any apps it finds that are using lots of power. And in this case, you saw no apps. But if I was running a bunch of them and I really wanted to know what was draining the battery, it's interesting to have that indicator. Safari is pretty much the same, but it brings out this new concept of a sidebar. We've had that before. You clicked on Reading List and you saw your reading list here, but Bookmarks is now there as well. And you can basically use this left sidebar for Bookmarks, Reading List. It'll even show you links from your Twitter feed if you've set up Twitter in your system preferences. So it kind of creates this other way to surf with stuff here on the sidebar in a similar way to you've seen in some other apps with items in a sidebar and then viewing here in the window. Kind of reminds me of how Mail works, or how iTunes used to work. And some people will definitely find this kind of useful. You also have the iCloud keychain. So you're going to be able to have similar functionalities before. In Safari Preferences here, you can see under Passwords, I've got websites, and I can look at the passwords that have been saved for different websites and better manage what's saved. But the neat thing is, of course, this will sync with iCloud. So on my other Mac, I will have the same passwords and IDs for a site, and of course this will happen over iOS as well. You've also got new multi-screen functionality in Mavericks. It's hard to show here, but basically you can have docs across your screens and menu bars across your screens, making it a little easier to work with multiple displays. So there's a quick overview of what's new in Mavericks. Of course, I'll be going more detail into some of these features in future episodes and tutorials at MacMost.com.